not just be employable after 2 years, to be successful in your careers year on year. And that practice often is not given in organizations. You cannot test your fundamentals at a workplace. It would be disaster. Workplace is no laboratory. Workplace is a place where it is action. Yes, some amount of acceptance will be there on failures, but gross negligence is unpardonable because you will be putting the organization at stake, you are putting the team members in stake. So before you do, first P stands for planning. Have your plan. If your 2021 is something you want to achieve, have your plan right now. Very clear. The next is make sure that you have something which is on the practice part of it so that you can achieve that, right? Before you become perfect. Any questions? So what are the ones which we have said? I know all of you would forget, but before I close the session, I thought I will make a quick important points which I said. First one which said is aspiration is very clear. Have your logics clear. If 5 is equal to 25, have a check. Education is not for employment. Make sure you are using more on professional networking than the Facebooks of all. I am no way saying don't do Facebooks. Please go ahead and do. But it will not give you that much growth as professional networking. You all believed that 2 crores, if you was there, you will put it in some shares. But somebody has put that money into you. So make sure that you are more valuable than shares and mutual funds or fixed deposits at least. Don't just get away from this institute for getting a qualification. Don't get an A4 size paper passed. Okay. So make sure that you contribute to the function and also be an alumni like our friend who is there, Mr. Moli. Right. Develop your business acumen. The 5 P's: plan, prepare, practice, participate, and then become a perfectionist for everything which you do. Among all this, do not forget the most important aspect, the 10th aspect, enjoy. Okay, this is a place where you can enjoy, right? You would hardly get somebody who is more cooperative than a faculty. You would hardly get persons who are more, even though they are seniors, they will feel that, okay, ye bhi apna hi bhai chara aadmi hai, chalo isko satate nahi, thode din pehle satayenge, baad mein chhod denge. Right? Even when you become a senior, then you will know this. So this is a place where you can have a lot of fun, and you need to enjoy, right? And you can connect to whatever you want. But once you go into an office, boss, he will set up in even though it looks like a transparent glass room or in cubicle, you are actually boxed. Your out of box thinking is not used. Because uska box use karna hai na. So make sure that you are learning and getting best of your place, and enjoy every moment in this campus. All the best and take care of yourself. Thank you.
The importance of aspirations, the need to be networking, the need to connect with other people. He also talked about the importance, or rather the lack of importance, of grades. Grades is not the only thing. He then told you that your parents have made an investment in you, and the return would depend upon what you do over the next 2 years over here. You need to have a mastery of the subject. We talked about the significance of practice and the need to have out-of-the-box thinking. All in all, he has told you in a very limited time what exactly you need to be doing over the next 2 years. You will have today as well as tomorrow a few other speakers who would be talking on those lines but in their own different way. May I now request Varalani to introduce the next speaker, Mr. Chandramouli.
Mr. Chandramouli is the Global Head, Learning and Development at Scient Limited. It's a company with more than 13,000 employees across 40 locations. Over the last 17 years, he has served as a consultant, businessman, and HR professional. Prior to Scient, he worked for KPMG and Deloitte. He is passionate about adding value to the development of people and help realize potential. Most importantly, I'm happy to inform you that Mr. Chandramouli has graduated from IPE in the year 1999. A warm welcome to you, sir.
I'm very glad to be here. One of the reasons is so many young people I get to interact with. Another reason is somebody who taught me, somebody who helped me to be like this today, they are also here. One, Narendranath Menon, two, Professor Srinivas Murthy. A big round of applause from my side, probably. Thank you. So I graduated in 99. Of late, I started realizing that people don't respect for my age. I hit 40 years recently. Last month, I hit in the month of April. I have 17 years experience. I worked as a CEO for a couple of years. I worked for about 10 years as a consultant for global companies, KPMG or Deloitte. These are 2 lakh employees companies. I worked as a director, as a senior manager, managing some of the functions for India and outside the country. Last 3 years, I'm basically cooling my heels in the name of HR professional, some L&D professional. I train like this. The difference is here, you dedicate yourself for education. There, the guys must be doing sales or delivery or operations. I somehow manage to get their time, train them, help them realize what they are little more so that they can fare well in their jobs. I think a couple of things I will share. We will, how many of you have more than 2 years of work experience? Raise your hand. Thank you. Yeah. For you, I may appear boring and repetitive. For others, probably new. Yeah. So I think the best times of our life will be when somebody sponsors our expenses. In India especially, we are so lucky, sometimes our parents take care of us till the age of 30 years. I know some people who hang around in Jubilee Hills, Banjara Hills, or near my house. Yeah, who even at the age of 35 depend on father's, parents' money or inherited property. Yeah, that's only probably unique to India. Yeah? This is the best time that we can have one fun to make meaning out of life and then find a way and move forward. Yeah. You are in those best times probably 2 more years. If your parents are rich, if you have inherited property, then you can experiment for longer time. Yeah? See if you can make use of that experimentation time. Yeah? As you go on and start contributing to the society, either through direct employment, I can't be better than Mr. Pradeep. I think he was acute business professional. If anybody has to take, I want to grow as a businessman, probably just follow him through the next 1 decade or so, you will be there. Yeah? So as we move towards serving the society or contributing to the society or providing services to somebody so that we can realize value out of it, we come across multiple opposites, multiple dichotomies. I'll give one example for opposites. Which side of the road should we drive? Say it loudly. Which side of the road should we drive? So left side, is it? So at least I am driving on the left side on this road. Yeah, and generally on the roads. There are some regions where we drive on the other side, right? Is that correct? Sorry? So basically different countries, different regions, they drive on either side of the roads. And both are correct. Agree with me? Yeah, so there is a fundamental flaw with this right and wrong. I'll share with you. If majority of a society decides one thing is right, then whether it is right or wrong, that will be right. Agree with me? Yes. Yeah. So if a majority of population in any society decides something is right, who said whether right is correct, right side driving is right, or left side driving is right? Yeah. So the society, majority of them would have determined, and there are few outliers, they don't sustain or they don't sustain for longer. Now, similarly in work life, you will have multiple opposites, multiple dichotomies. I will share 4 of them now. Yeah. Number one, all of us are expected to have a point of view. Yeah. Something like by end of 2 years, you should know at least the names of these trees. If nothing else, if you have not understood, anyways, macroeconomics, accounting, we can't understand. I am a HR professional. Where is the scope? Sorry, I don't know other disciplines. Otherwise, they are equally difficult to understand. Yeah. So at least we are expected to have a point of view about the plantation here and whether that wind is useful to us or not. Am I making sense again? Yeah. Now, while we are expected to have a point of view, we share our views clearly, crisply, and confidently. There is also an opposite thing. We are expected to be flexible. Yeah. I can't identify a worse example than this I would like to quote. Last week, my 3.5-year child came back with a complaint. Apparently, his teacher said that she wanted to meet us. So we went, and the complaint was like this. We got to know through the driver, through somebody else. Complaint was that, ma'am, if you threaten me, I'll have my dad come and beat you with a belt. Now, I got to be flexible, at least I learned that. So I removed my belt. If you look at, I'm not wearing even now. Said, I don't even wear belt, where will I beat, ma'am? I think, jokes apart, I think we are expected to be flexible all the time. What is right when I talk to somebody becomes absolutely wrong when I talk to somebody else. We are expected to adopt. We've got to flow along with the water. So while we have a clear point of view about everything that we do, why should we have a school so far? Why should we work at particular time? Why should we do things in a way that we want to do? Or why should we work and not work? We got to have a point of view. Second thing, anything that we do, we got to have outcomes, business results. Yeah? Business results, we say, it has to be counted in three formats. One, top line, we say, revenue. I don't know beyond this, only whatever I know, I'll share. Afterwards, they will take care. Second is bottom line, which is profit. Revenue is sales that I generate. Bottom line is profit that I get. Third thing is, with less efforts, I should get more profit. So anything that we do, we have to keep our business results in mind and then work. So I'm sure people who worked in the past, you agree with me. Some of you who worked, you agree with me. Now, the dichotomy here is, you got to be empathetic towards people around you. You got to be sensitive towards others. If I'm very sensitive to people around, I'm supposed to also favor them or support them. Yes, no? Yes. Now, sometimes when I'm supporting others, for example, today, this is Monday. I'm expected to clock 8 hours or 8.5 hours time in office. Yeah. Now, I also felt I'm an alumni. I graduated from this college only. I told you about zero he gave in midterm, etc. So I don't have any other feelings. I managed to get good score in the finals and I cleared more than 50 marks I got. I think the important aspect is I realized that I got to be empathetic. So should I, can I give back anything to my college? Now, in business or in your work life, you commonly come across this dichotomy. Should you be making earnings out of your every hour or should you be empathetic towards your team? Sometimes I think more important is you have to be empathetic to your managers. Now you have to be empathetic towards your parents. They invest so much money on you and yet they can't open a mouth in front of you. Your parents invest so much money on you and yet some parents don't get chance to open mouth in front of you. Yeah. If anybody connects with it, keep this in mind. This is the fate of your manager and employer also. They would like to facilitate the process for you. They may not be so empathetic because they may not have that greater sense of belonging with you. Otherwise, they equally support you. They to a large extent support you and your response is more likely to be the way you take care of, you treat your parents at this stage. Yeah? So therefore, recommendation is maintain balance between business results and empathy. Third one. We got to, so the one way to look at is since we have born here and we got to have, let me also look at, I made the note of this. Yeah. So we have invested 10 lakh rupees here, 2 years time you are spending here, which is 700 odd days, 715 days. And you may have college for 250 days. Out of 750 days, will you have college for 250 days here? Something like more than that, is it? Yeah. So you got to get the returns out of it. So if you invest the same money in a bank or in real estate, other areas, it may turn realize into 2 crore rupees. So we got to earn money. Right from the day out of your college, you are expected to go dedicate your efforts towards a company or so and so and make realize money out of it. This is one way to look at. The opposite of it is we got sheerly lucky. So also some of it is related to my age. Yeah, we got so lucky and we got all these benefits and facilities. And so many people around who are not equally lucky. So we call it as serving the society. What is right here? Earning and realizing revenues out of efforts is correct or serving the society is correct?
Beyond just money. Sorry, I'm taking a minute, sir. I feel that, so I have had work experience, so probably this should make more sense. So I think this sort of goes beyond money, like you were mentioning time. You have to earn this time to be able to spend it. So I think it probably connects back to the dichotomy you're talking about. You need to have one of them to actually do the other. So you can't actually choose one of them in that sense. But it's important to do both.
Yeah, so these dilemmas are, for each one of us, the dilemma could be different. Residual value is we can't manage both the things well unless we are extremely conscious about balancing it. What he shared, I also echo him. I'm still not spending my Saturdays, Sundays for any other, you know, social service generally. It goes more for the family welfare. Yeah. So I have a fourth dichotomy. I'll hold it. At the moment, I will wait for. So I want to share briefly my story of my growth. 1996, I graduated in engineering. Got 76% from Bangalore. Only 6 out of 42 people actually cleared in 4 years' time. So it was in Bangalore, first time semester system. Our college is a government college, very difficult to progress also, definitely those days. 97, I joined IPE. I think the remarks in the panel was that, why is that engineers can't articulate, can't express views? That guy, but he was kind enough, he onboarded me into IPE. Yeah. 99, when I cleared, I realized that I should not become a, I don't have another word, I don't want to do a non-executive work, all the software programming, I felt not for me. Then there are few jobs, those days, I'm sure even now you may be getting, we had ONGC, we had Citibank's IT company used to be there, now probably hived off. They offered me a job. I felt, I don't think I fit for them. So I decided to join a company called Administrative Staff College of India. 99 for 3,500 by saying no to a 17,000 per month salary. Yeah, there the job was about doing some consulting work for public sector companies in India. 4 years' time, I learned so much about mechanical engineering and how industries work, how processes work. Then moved on, worked for 4 more years as an employee. Then I quit my job, wanted to be an entrepreneur. It was in the year 2009. 2009. I said, look, I have gained a lot of knowledge about performance. So I will align individual performance to organization performance. So apparently for small scale industries, the problem still exists. So I quit my job, had some money, came back to Hyderabad, then started the company. After a year and a half, we reflected, my wife and I, and we saw in the last, by then I was married for 5 years, in the last 5 years, we had never gone for outing and holidays so many times that we have gone, me being an entrepreneur. Yeah, every time I used to get a paycheck from a client, so 2 lakhs and above, I used to go on a holiday, 10 days break, all employees, they can decide. So after about 2 years, I think it was 20 months, I reflected, it was not working, company was not growing, salaries were increasing. When I reflected, I realized two things were not in my favor. One, my commitment towards vision was very limited. I wanted to do something really great for the probably small scale industries. I was more drifted by public sector companies. Those days, probably today I don't remember connections. At least the top 5 Navratnas, I would have had strong relation with them. So I used to get consulting project, used to travel, generally it is in Delhi, the corporate office. Used to hang around in a nice 5-star hotel for a week or so. Yeah. One, what I lacked was vision dilution. I didn't have commitment towards vision. Two, another mistake I did was I ran the show alone. So the moment I run the show alone, there is nobody to check whether I am using my time for office purpose or personal purposes. Yeah. So therefore, again, we reflected on, decided I should get back to work. Probably there will be a day where again, what Mr. Pradeep said, I will one day become probably an entrepreneur. Till then, probably I'll cool my heels and join this workplace. Of course, I moved to KPMG and we wanted to come back to Hyderabad. So that's how I came to this company. Yeah? So two things that would have helped me, whatever growth that I have had, despite I tried as an entrepreneur multiple times, only once I was successful, that too for about 22 months. It didn't last beyond that. There are two reasons I shared. Before that, I failed multiple times. probably two or three times I failed. 1.5 years after the college, somebody hired me as a CEO for an IT company, Sanju's junior's batch. Yeah, 2 years junior to me, their relative hired me as a CEO for an IT company. So what has happened for me? Why did I get an opportunity? One, I think the belief that I had on the things I knew. Yeah. So I repeatedly told you the message of one of the professors gave me 0 out of 25. I had sheer confidence. This is an accounts subject and you gave theoretical questions. I don't think I want to write. That was a reason. Except for one problem, rest all was theory in financial accounting. So what confidence I had, I know the subject, I can do well. If you give me 0, I can always manage it at the end of, in the final test. And we had those whatever interim tests. So I think one, confidence on the subject that I knew, that helped me succeed. Two, the fundamental values, whatever I believe in, I was able to actually stick to that instead of diluting in general. Yeah. If I've said I'm graduating from IPE, probably even now some of the topics, though it will be vague, demand and supply, what was taught in macroeconomics, I can draw the line even now. Or mechanical engineering, many subjects. This morning I was interviewing somebody with 6 years experience. I asked her, what is Dale's cone of experience you will learn in HR, if anybody goes into HR. She said, I studied long ago, I don't remember. I really wondered. I studied that way 18 years ago. How do I remember? I think somewhere it is in me that if I say I am learning it, I sincerely learn that. I thought I'll share this with you, and best wishes. We'll go for more of question and answer later. Thank you. I will take the honors. I want Mr. Sanju Pillai to come and address for 5 minutes here. Come Sanju, get up. He's our junior.
Somewhere I had a feeling that he is giving us three versions and whether it was a trichotomy and trilemma. But what he said in essence, Mr. Chandramouli, you need to have a point of view. Everybody, what is your view on this issue? What is your view on that issue? You please keep reading the papers. Yesterday, is this guy Siddharth over here? I sent a mail to him. Yesterday, he sent me two YouTubes, one with Gaddafi and the other with Idi Amin. And today, he has sent me two more YouTube presentations. What were they? One with some, all these.